Yes, welcome to the Dirt Shed Show, where this week we're talking about high stakes riding coming up over the next few weeks. So let me set this up, Neil. We've got Mont Saint Anne this weekend.
Favourite place of mine, love it.
It's an amazing track, and it's the final race of the World Cup downhill season for XC and downhill. But yep. I feel like there's some big changes coming next year. There's some rocky teams. And when I say rocky, will they, won't they be there next year?
That's true.
How much is at stake for these riders this weekend when basically a win could secure them a pro deal next year and a loss could guarantee they don't get a pro deal?
There will be a lot of pro riders looking at this weekend as their very last chance to prove that they can be a professional mountain biker.
Yes.
And we're going to a classic venue, classic track for both cross country and downhill, to be fair, but I'm sort of looking at the downhillers because that's where I know it best. And I've been there, done that, when you're nearing the end of your contract and it's the end of the season. You've got to do something, otherwise you'll probably be looking for a new job next year. Mm. This is off the back of, just a couple of weeks ago, an official document being leaked, Warner Brothers Discovery document, about the progression of mountain bike racing.
That's right.
And talking about less top-tier teams at the World Cup, which could mean there's a supply crunch for those top rides. So there's only so many, you know, sponsored rides going around and people are all fighting for their same amount of rides. So there'll be some riders that I'm looking at who think they've got to do it this weekend.
Yeah.
I think Reese Wilson's a good example of someone who's just done it. Riding for Trek, he's obviously was a former world downhill champion, but his last win was back in 2021. Fortunately for Reese, he did really well at Lunenville. He got second place.
Yeah, second place, he was on fire.
Exactly. I think he'll obviously be looking to back that up, but that's an example of someone who's just done that thing that we're talking about here. Benoit Coulange has obviously been performing really, really well.
But he's just won, right?
Exactly. But his team, Dorval Commensal, have announced that they won't be existing next year. And Madison Saracen are another team who said they're not going to be around next year. I would hope Benoit probably has got a ride. I don't know that, but you'd hope so, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Camille Balanche is in that situation. She's not had a great... She had a rough injury last year.
But injured now, so...
Exactly. So she's not actually riding Mont Saint Anne. So she's in a pretty sticky situation, I would presume.
It's tricky. It feels like, for all of these races, it's almost like a heavyweight boxing situation. Like, they are one punch or one knockout away from it all being on or over.
And don't forget the young'uns coming up and people like the juniors coming up, Ace of them, Met, Aries van Leeuwen, but also the really hot riders like Lockie Stevens-McNabb, who's just won the US Open. He will be looking for a top ride next year. And there are already rumours of him going to Trek to replace Loris Vergier, who apparently might be going to an Andorran manufacturer. Don't forget, actually, there are more positive news. I don't think we've done this before, but there are rumours of some new team. So, what can I say, a Spanish team who's never had a downhill team before.
Yeah.
Or Bayer, I've got to say. There are rumours that they are coming. Obviously, Martin Mays has been riding their e-bike. It would make sense for them to bring a downhill bike to the scene and have a team.
Yeah.
Not confirmed.
I mean, so there you go. That's the World Cup bit at the moment. The risks those riders are going to be taking. Like I say, one slide out on a corner, one crash, it could be all over. And they're going to be going flat out because they need those wins. Yeah. And in World Cup downhill, anyone in the top 20 could potentially win.
It's true.
You know what I mean? They can all put a run together that's so quick, it could win a World Cup. Well, so it's going to be fireworks.
Even Loris Vergier, top rider, you know, he hasn't done exactly what he would hope until the world champs. And all of a sudden, Loris Vergier, world champion. That turns it all around.
Yeah, secures the deal. Of course, we've also got another event where risk really comes into it. Red Bull Rampage is just beginning. The tracks are just going to start being built now.
Yeah,
the riders
there
are working on their lines. And this is a different, I guess, a different angle on the risks. And I do it with a slightly sober tone to begin with, because obviously over in the World Road Championships, we've seen this week how dangerous cycling in general is, because there was the unbelievably unfortunate situation where Muriel Fuhrer passed away through a head injury that she got in the Junior World Championship road race. Terrible news and an awful reminder of how dangerous cycling is in general. But with that on our minds and using that as context, let's think about Red Bull Rampage. And what those riders, men and women, because they're both competing this year, yeah. are taking on when they go to that event. And are the risks worth it, Neil?
I sometimes have like a mixed relationship, I think, with Rampage. Like, I get excited it's coming, and then when it's here, it does frighten me, to be honest. Mm. And I've not been there and seen it in first hand or, you know, ever tried to ride that this sort of style of riding either.
And that's a really good point, because one thing that's in, it looks amazing on video, right?
Yeah.
I can guarantee it is 10 times scarier than that in real life.
Imagine being a pro and having to deal with that. You know, really luckily, we've got some content coming to the channel soon. Mm. Blake is going out to Utah next week, and he will be following a Red Bull Rampage rookie and be seeing firsthand exactly how, I don't know what the word is, worrying, scary, adrenaline-fueled, how fired up these riders are going to be for this massive event in the desert.
Yeah, I mean, I think Blake's going to get a real shock. I think he's going to be incredibly excited by it, because he loves that stuff.
And this would have been on his radar at one point, obviously.
Yeah, but I think he's going to be glad he's not riding it once he sees it, because it is terrifying. I mean, I've seen Ben Deacon just talking about he wouldn't even dig on one part of the course that Brendan Fairclough rode last year. What did they call it? It was the very top bit of the course.
Oh, I don't know.
Something. And it was just terrifying. He couldn't even dig up there, let alone think about riding a bike on it. So imagine how scary that must be.
Yeah.
But I question myself when I'm thinking of watching it each year.
I do,
just because, obviously, over the years, there has been massive accidents at Red Bull Rampage. GF and only recently had a really awful crash trying something absolutely insane.
I spoke to
60-foot drop.
Ollie Wilkins about that, and he said he couldn't watch him ride off that. He thought he knew how it was going to go, and it went that way.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, probably most infamous, Paul Bascotia, just, you know, had an awful crash, a resulting spinal cord injury as was life-changing and career-ending for him. So it's high risk, high stakes. So I'm always a little bit uneasy. I guess I'm the same as you, but I...
Do you still watch it?
No, I don't watch it live anymore. No, I can't do it. I watch the clips afterwards that are being celebrated. You know, when they're everywhere, I feel safe.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, cool, it went well, or it went bad, but they wouldn't be showing it, hopefully, if it's not... And I struggle with it.
I'd like to know the viewers' opinion on this. I find it difficult because sometimes it takes ages. You get their first run and the wind happens. I'm like, okay, I've had enough now. You have to, and it kind of ruins the competitive element a little bit. And they're so sort of governed by what's going on with the wind that it's not always the best watch.
One thing I'd say about it is that the World Cups we were talking about, these people who go out and try and win a World Cup race this weekend, they will get a deal next year if they do that.
Yeah.
The guys and girls who are riding at Red Bull Rampage, I don't think it means security in their future as a professional rider. Probably would do if you won Red Bull Rampage.
Yeah.
But I don't know if it's worth the risk. I really don't. And it got me thinking about that recent post from Lewis Buchanan, who did that crazy roll, and he got some serious heat online for, like,
and it's
taking the risk.
Arguably the same thing. You're getting eyes on yourself to get, you know, money.
Yeah, I mean, look at this clip. It's really terrifying. He only just gets away with that. That could have gone... I mean, we could be talking about this in a very different way, but for a few metres. Mm. So... It begs the question whether it's really worth it. Are the risks worth taking? But he says, he makes a very good argument on that very post. It's like, look, this is my life. This is what I like to do. I want to take these risks. Do we want to watch him take those risks? That's the question. I guess it's a question for ourselves.
I mean, it all started with Evel Knievel. That's the same thing repeating itself with different walks of,
walks of life,
but actually types of sport. It's all over the world. It might be base jumping or whatever. Yeah. It's the same thing.
Yeah.
Risk versus reward.
I have unfortunately heard that Evel Knievel was a total dick.
I've heard that.
Yeah. That's a shame, because I had the toy and everything. It's gutting to find that out. Right, look, I've got three questions for you guys, right? I really want to see you in the comments. Please get in the comments and tell me what you think about this, because I think this is actually, you know, really pivotal for us all as mountain bikers, what this stuff means. So in terms of Rampage, is it worth the risk? Give us your thoughts on that. Will you be watching it? That's a really good question. I can't do it. World Cup downhill. Who is going to be putting it all on the line in Mount St Anne? And who really needs to? Who are the riders you're waiting to see? So get quick on that because it's about to happen. And then social influencers. You know, art is a risk. Like, let's use Lewis Buchanan's post as an example. Is that worth doing to get views, clicks, likes? Is it worth it? Oh, I don't know. Let's go to the news with Tom.
What's up, everyone? Last week saw the release of the latest round of Fox Live Valve technology with their Neo Shocks. There's wireless tech in there, which allows the settings to change as they adapt to the input of what you're riding in just 14 milliseconds. With 3 years of testing under its belt at both Enduro and Downhill World Cups, Fox have now fielded the X2 and DHX coil to market, the package along with the sensors and batteries costing around $1,400. Via the companion app, you can introduce tunes to select for the different areas or types of trail that you ride, which essentially will confine the shock to different parameters for your rides. Clothing company 7Mesh have released their autumn and winter lineup of clothing, including base layers, trousers, jackets, and riding hoodies. As someone who gets hot in a jacket but lives in rainy old England, I certainly love a good technical riding hoodie. Check out the 7Mesh lineup on their website for pricing. Muckoff have released a mini inflator, which could replace a pump on your rides if you don't like pumping. It's pocket-sized and can take your tyres up to 100 psi via either a Presta or Schrader connection, charging in 25 minutes via a USB-C port. The website says it charges up to two 700C by 25mm tyres up to 80 psi in roughly 80 to 90 seconds per charge. £90 for that one. 1UP Components' 1% giveback program, donating 1% of their profits to environmental groups, bike charities, and trail associations around the world, has reached the $1 million milestone. What do these donations look like in real life? Well, 600,000 trees planted through Eden, 750 Buffalo bikes mobilizing approximately 3,700 people through World Bicycle Relief, and tools, beers, and more donated to trail building organizations who create our playgrounds. Top work, 1UP. Crankworx have announced their 2025 dates. Next year opens with a summer series round in Christchurch, New Zealand in February before Rotorua in March, Cairns in May, another round of the summer series in Silver Star in August before Whistler, and finally closing things out at Sugarloaf. Lake Placid UCI Mountain Bike World Series results now. Spoilers for about the next 30 seconds if you've not seen the race yet. That course was fast. These guys and girls looked like they were absolutely burying themselves for the best part of an hour. Remember to catch all the racing live and on demand on Discovery Plus and Max. Starting with the under-23s, Kira Bom and Dario Lillo took victories in the XCC, Isabella Holmgren and Cole Punchard taking victory in the Olympic distance, the Canadians' first under-23 win on the international stage. In the elite, it was Sina Fry taking her first win of the year and Viktor Koretsky taking the win in his short track world champs colours in the XCC. Koretsky also took the win in the XCO, series leader Alan Haverly coming in second, getting those vital points for the overall. Laura Stigger got her first win of the year as she just outsprinted Sina Fry, who equaled her career best of second in the elite XCO, almost a perfect weekend for her. Bit more racing in the States this weekend too. Nina Hoffman and Lucky Stevens-McNabb were the fastest in Fox US Open downhill in Killington Mountain. That's all for me this week. Back to the guys in the shed.
Thank you, guys. Rob, got a competition to announce, Neil.
I've heard this.
Yes.
Mine, Ergon.
Ergon. We've got three bundles of Ergon mountain bike gear to give away. Your touch points, your grips and your seats on the bike.
And for your bell as well, of course.
Yeah, or if you've got a bell, you can put a grip on. It's very simple to enter. You just head to the description down below this video. You'll be asked to answer a question about the products. But this is cool because you can basically get an Ergon. It's Ergon by name, Ergon by nature, really.
The stuff
they make is measured, it is precise, it is comfortable, and that's what they're all about. So this is great stuff. You also get a pair of gloves with that kit.
To say, big full range of gear that you can choose from, and you get a set of gloves too.
Yeah, so that's the bundle. You get your mountain bike, touch points and your gloves. Get that question, and you could find out if you're the winner on the Dirt Shed Show in 2 weeks' time.
Yes.
Good deal, right?
Yeah.
Also, of course, YouTube memberships is live and unleashed on our channel.
Thank you very much. The people that have done it already. It's amazing.
So much. I'm a trail boss, Neil.
Yeah, well done.
Yeah, I love it. It's really good fun, actually. The emojis are brilliant. There's the two tiers. There's trail crew and trail boss. we really appreciate you getting involved with this. It's really important to see that support and help us make videos. That's what it's all about at the end of the day.
We love your support. And of course, the shop is open, JBN store, yeah, where we have got this new bikepacking gear t-shirt that Rich is modeling right here. So if you're into that and you want to help support the channel, then we love it. Thank you very much.
Do you know what? He's got that t-shirt in every single colour.
I saw
that. Have you even got one?
No, I don't.
I haven't got one.
Took them all.
Yeah, he's got one in every colour. Yeah, I tell you what, I want to try something else as well. Have you heard about Super Thanks?
Is that like Superman or Super Ted?
No, Super Thanks on our channel. This is really cool. I mean, this is a big ask, but we would be so grateful if you take a look at it. You can basically touch the three dots on just below the video. I guess it would be just over there. And you can give us a thanks, like a tip.
I saw this. I sent it to Steve. Steve Jones on EMBN did his DJI one out in Italy. It was amazing. And somebody who said they didn't even have an email invite but loved the video.
Yeah.
A big long comment. And they donated, is it dollars? I think it is all measured in dollars. It was $9.99. I couldn't, but I sent it to Steve. Good. I was like, check this out. And jealous. Steve replied, yeah, some lunatics watched EMBN and GMBN.
Yeah, so I won't push it too hard. It's there. I wanted to let you know. You have to go and find it. But if you give us a super thanks, that would be so great. I'd be so chuffed. So it's there. I'm just letting you know. But no pressure, all right? No pressure. But yeah, it's a great way to support us on all of those things through the shop, through the memberships, and of course the super thanks. Appreciate your support. All right, let's earn some of that support now. Let's keep going with the show.
Yes.
I've got to sing now, Neil. Hacks and Bodges!
I'll pay you not
Hacks and Bodges, they're singing Hacks and Bodges.
Can I pay you not to sing?
If Neil sings, who will give us a super thanks?
You're wasting money, don't do that.
None of you.
Don't do that.
Here we go.
Starting with Bernard Hable, and I've seen one of these before, but I do like it, and I think it's a really good idea.
It looks so simple, it's very clever.
A break bleeding block, not as easy to say.
No.
And you kind of, or Bernard, has cut away one quarter of it, I guess, so that if you get sticky pistons, you ever had that with brakes? You make your sort of lever feel dirty and horrible, and they don't basically return. It's probably because the pistons in your caliper have got dirty and corroded. And basically, you need to get them out to clean them and re-lube them. And you want to do it one at a time. And you don't want to pop it all the way out, done that, because then you just...
Who knew they just popped out?
Yeah, they pop out.
Yeah.
If you take your brake pads out and you keep pumping your lever, eventually they just go... Bleh.
Yeah. But this is really cool because it helps you isolate one piston at a time.
And I've seen people get some like degreaser, get some cleaner on there, and then you get a little cotton bud, and then you put a bit of O-ring grease
Love
around
it.
There.
Loves it.
Good idea.
Great. I mean, it's going to be hard to beat this week, though, isn't it? Because it's so simple. We could all do that with something
on
our garage.
Blocks,
but it's very good. I would like to combat that with this from Erica, friend of the channel.
Yeah.
Erica is a vet. Okay, so I'm sure she told me she was a vet. Now, obviously, as a vet, you have to put them big gloves on, like she's got there, and
why?
You know, they're for cows and horses and things.
Yeah, tell me.
You know, checking. All but right. She's come up with some very useful mountain bike uses for those gloves.
Oh my gosh! I hope they're fresh ones.
I mean, I would argue, Erica, that we haven't all got them gloves. By the way, we aren't checking horses and cows that often. But it's useful.
Can't remember last
I quite
time
like it. Who are you going to give the race top to? Bearing in mind that Erica's a great friend of the channel.
Well, yeah, now you're putting pressure on me.
Who's going to win the race top this week? Is it Erica or is it Bernd?
Bernd. I don't know, Mike. Can we give away two? Because I'm going to feel
guilty.
We've
got it because Bernd earned it because it's a really good hack and bodge. You got yourself a GMBM race top, and Erica, you just get one because you're a friend of the channel.
Yeah.
That's fair enough. Right. If you've got a hack or a bodge, send it into our uploader. We love seeing them. I like seeing the very simple ones. Like that one from Bernd was the perfect example. So simple, and it really helps you keep your bike working. So, got a hack or a bodge? Send it into the uploader like you would your bike vault or your sends or your fails. We've been getting a lot of sends and fails recently.
I've been seeing them on our Instagram.
Yes.
Lots of both.
Can I show you a couple of fails?
Feel free.
Look at this one. This is the gap of death. It doesn't look that big, does it? But look, whack!
It's bigger than it looks
when you get the scale
of the bike.
How didn't he get over it? It's not even a bike's length.
I bet that hurt.
Yeah, I bet it did. Well done, Tommy. I like that one. We also had this one from Alexander. This is an, I like this one because, you know, our risk versus reward, is it worth it? Oh. 8.5-foot drop, is it worth it, Neil? Should you do it if you see that on your trail?
Yeah.
Go for it.
That looks... What
would be your advice to an 8.5-foot drop? Lean back and hope?
Oh, a bit of speed if you can. Don't overshoot the landing. But going slow makes things a bit more dicey.
Also, this one from Raffy Sloan. I quite like this. This is risk versus reward on speed. He is going for it. Rap! And we're away.
Ah, weird. Like, got hit something soft and got stalled.
Bucked out. Nasty.
It was going so well.
It was. Like a few fails. If you've got sends or fails.
Yep.
Send me. I'm a presenter, you know.
Since when?
Yeah.
10 years? At least.
Right, let's take a look at some things we like this week. Yeah, first one this week from Legend of Trials.
Op P.
I've tried to do this.
Yeah.
That is very hard. I mean, it's Op P. Well, it's still very, very good. Oh, but that is
Martin,
hard.
Of course, Martin. It's very nice to finally have a Trials Legend in the show.
Very funny.
Is that the sixth time, seventh time? Probably.
Yeah, you guys do that joke constantly. It's unbelievable.
But yeah, quite funny.
Hey, look, that is Op P. It's a different level of legend to all trials riders.
I didn't know who Op P was until about 9 years ago.
Wake up, Neil. He's literally designed the sport himself
on
paper.
That.
He was like side hop. That might look a bit like this. And then did them.
Well, I've ridden a roller and I know how difficult it is just to ride straight on a roller.
Yeah, I mean, that's unreal. But he's still doing it. Next thing I wanted to look at is this. Well, I don't know what you think about this. Bimotals. Basically, bolt-on motor that they reckon's got enough torque that would turns your downhill bike into an uplift. And you can hit the trails. They've got these new disc sizes.
223mm rotor. To go on the back of a bike, it's got to be back, has it? To drag your bike?
Yes, it's on the back. And basically, every time you put one of these motors on, it would be the size up from the disc you're using on your bike.
How many bikes are going to fit a 223mm rotor at the rear?
I mean,
not many.
I just brought it up, right, because I think it's something we should test out. Because it looks torquey.
It does.
It might be a great way for me to... get some power on my bucket.
Are they all throttle? They're not throttle. Are they pedal?
I think they're thumb button.
Well,
thumb
I do not know.
As well. But I'd like to test them out. Let us know what you think about those. And lastly, right, first I want to mention this near miss on Dovey Bike Parts. This is Henry Timewell, right? Look at that near miss.
I've been there, done that. That is the,
scary.
What's it called? The Gully of Doom?
Yeah.
Dovey. It's a sketchy bit of track, and there is...
Ooh, it's frightening.
Quite often.
But I was going to mention him anyway, because his friend texted me on Instagram messages.
Nice.
He said, you've got to mention my dude, Henry Timewell, because he's just become British Enduro champ again in juniors. I think he's already run it twice before. And he's a rider worth mentioning on the up, you know, taking those risks, needs the support. So there's a name to watch for the future because he's winning a lot. And if you've got a rider, a friend of yours or yourself, and you want to get some props on the Dirt Shed Show, send me a message on Instagram. I will, if I see it, I will mention you on the show. And who knows, you might get sponsorship from it. Does it work that well? Is it that easy?
It's as easy as
it might not be that easy, but I'll mention you anyway.
How often do you check your messages on Instagram?
I do check them often.
Oh,
I promise, yeah, I do look at those. Caption contest! Neil, did you hear last week? Did you hear the news about last week's caption contest with Steve's face?
No.
We didn't get any captions for it.
Wow, was that the right reaction?
Possibly.
Was it funny?
Possibly. But it's the first time it ever happened.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie, it worried me. But thankfully, we put this picture up of Blake last week, and we have got some captions.
That is not a Blake face he pulls very often, is it?
No, you don't see him grumpy often, and I was worried nobody wanted the stunt mugs.
But they do. Yeah, Dickie Smith MTB says, your choices are for Mega Avalanche, Martin in the random tandem. Well, that's been talked about, and has it been shot down, Martin? I don't know.
I'd love to do it.
Would you?
Yeah.
Well, Blake doesn't look like he does. And then for full suspension BMX or Brompton.
Yeah.
I think I'd choose the full suspension BMX out of all those.
Poor Blake, that's basically what we throw at him all the time.
He suggests
Blake,
the most
Blake, we've
time.
Come up with another crazy idea for you.
It's his idea.
You must get frustrated. Jan Henroyt he says, when Blake builds, wonders why he hasn't thought of building a lawnmower bike before. Yes, on last week's show, we had a lawnmower bike. It's screaming Blake builds at it. A bike that also cuts the lawn.
Yeah.
Rich loved it. I thought it was terrible, but there you go.
Blake's got one of them robot lawnmowers, though, so he doesn't need that one. He only builds stuff that he wants, because then he can... Brandon Swift. Blake giving us a "you want me to do what now?" face after discussing the next next week's video ideas.
Yeah. Like I said, we throw some ideas at that boy. Who are you picking, Neil? I'm going to send this mug right at him.
I think Dickie Smith, MTB, is a good
Dickie,
one.
On its way! Boink. That was nearly a perfect bounce. If you would like to win yourself a stump mug like this one, then please give us a caption for this. Please give us a caption for this. And you could win yourself a stunt mug. It's a great deal. Put it in the comment section down below. You could be next week's winner. Coming up on the channel this week, Neil.
Blake is shooting. Signs, you might be a mountain biker. What do you think? I suggested owning a Volkswagen Transporter, but it didn't make the cut, apparently.
No?
Because I parked a bike part of Wales and there were six of them in a row.
That's a good sign that you're a mountain biker. Yeah. We've also got how to ride uphill and downhill switchbacks.
I did that one up in Scotland, because I find...
Bit of stock action.
I hate switchbacks, but I neither like them uphill or downhill. But I give my tips on... I use the back brake as a sort of clutch when you're going up the hill to keep you balanced.
Yeah. Weirdly, on the random tandem, you have to use the front brake to do that.
Yeah. Tricky, that, though, surely.
Oh, it's very... there's only certain switchbacks on the random tandem.
You have to say.
Weirdly, as a trials rider, switchbacks is where all of your skills as a trials rider come into superpowers.
You can do an endo on an endo 180 on a bar.
We're all about the switchbacks. We've also got enduro versus downhill. Are downhill bikes pointless?
Well, that was Rich's point of view, but I proved him wrong, of course.
Did you?
I was on the downhill bike.
Of course.
We've
also got how hard can you shred a BMX from Blake, and how to make your bike last longer and save money. Who doesn't want to know that?
Yep.
Some good videos this week. Do not miss out. Neil, let's get into the bike vault and see what you guys out there are riding. First bike in the bike vault this week is from Matty Thompson.
Transition. I don't know my transitions. Do you know what model?
Do you want me to tell you what I love about this shot?
Go on.
I love it. I just love the tire track moving away into the distance.
Yeah.
Because it just, I don't know, it gives that feeling of going somewhere. Yeah. I like it a lot. It's super nice for me. Super nice. Photo and bike.
Was this Harry Bowdler's Santa Cruz? Have we never not given Santa Cruz a super nice?
I'm not going to do it today.
All right.
It's just a nice for me.
Why?
Don't know, it's super nice. Changed my mind.
And now over to Barley. Barley Bike Park.
Barley Bike Park.
Wow. Jack Reed on his giant...
That's a giant rain.
Oh, no. I'm now Googling Barley Bike Park, because can we get there? How do we get to Barley Bike Park?
Well, that would be great, wouldn't it? Go and ride in Barley?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Right.
Is it in Barley?
There's a picture of... Is that Wynn? Yeah, that's Wynn.
We're zooming out. Stay with us, viewers.
No, it's in Merthyr Tydfil, funnily enough. Oh, no, it is in Barley.
Oh, God, I thought you were being serious then. I was like, how depressing. I like Merthyr Tydfil. I just expected Barley. That's the super nice. Took us on a journey there.
I mean, I'm ringing it already, because this is an Iron Horse Sunday in Slovakia. This is Paulie Savage's bike.
Why do you like that?
A bike because Sam Hill, obviously, although the bar end plug's hanging out.
Is that what Sam Hill rode originally, is
it? Well, that's really the... For me, that's golden years, Sam Hill. When it wasn't really golden years, because I was in the same races and he was making us all look stupid, but it was on an Iron Horse Sunday.
Okay. Oh, well, that makes sense.
And also is the Mad Cats Iron Horse team with Nathan Rennie, Bryn Atkinson, Sam Hill. Who else is on that team? It was a really strong team.
I tell you what, Bryn Atkinson still makes it look very, very good.
It does, yes.
I mean, obviously, he's from a time, but he's still very stylish.
From a time? What are you trying to say? It's from my time.
I'm not going to say anymore. next up is Teddy Loxton. Sounds a bit like Pippi Longstockings. Teddy Loxton. This is his Marin Alpine Trail.
It looks like a freshie, doesn't it?
It does, doesn't it? That's shiny. New. That is new.
I like that. I like a Marin. I have to change it. I said Marin.
That's a lot, is it? Really? Okay.
Marin.
Oh, and we're out of the pipe already. Is that it? God, it was a slight one this week.
Was that, they were all super nice.
I think that was an all super nice bike vault. Hey, why not? Bit of positivity. Thank you for sending your bikes in. If you have a bike, you must have one. Why else would you be watching this show? Please send it into the bike vault. We love seeing them. It's in the uploader down there. Obviously, you can also enter that competition to get the Ergon bundle and give us your comments on all the things we've been talking about this week. That's it for the Dirt Shed Show. Neil, where are you off to next?
That's a great question. Hospital, actually. Might have to get my knee checked out.
Let's end it on that. See you next week.
See ya.